It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1619, recorded Thursday, April 20th, 2017. What a concept! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, you better get moving because we are headed to the auto show. Three gadgets from there. Of course, we continue my magnetic month and a viewer video. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease.
Under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing blue and LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the aficionado of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, sir, and you?
I am doing great myself. It's been a pretty good week.
Good. I had adventures.
What?
On the high sea.
Oh, man.
I have my new boat and my old boat.
Oh, yes. You got the motor back.
I got my engine. No, it didn't stall.
No.
But I shipped the boat down on a trailer to Seabright, New Jersey, which is about 38 miles from where my marina is, and went down. And the guy said he ran the boat the day before and everything was good. And I brought Dennis and Captain Eddie Bacon from our marina, who is a charter captain, and who was great because we weren't sure about the waterways back there. And I have a new GPS, but it's not hooked up yet because it needs another kind of cable. Anyway, so it was great. And Seabright is behind this thing called Sandy Hook, which is land. But then there's about 10 or 15 miles of open ocean.
So you were worried because you're not going to take it back on a trailer. You're going to boat it back.
Yes, yes.
And
the ocean was pretty rocky. The seas were running 3 to 5 feet.
Whoa.
And my boat's only a 23-foot boat. Fortunately, this engine has a ton of power. So we were able to bounce across the waves doing a little bit of internal damage. Like the fan broke off the wall and a light came off the bulkhead.
Oh, no.
Yes. I know. I've been out in rough seas before, but when we got back, Dennis said, you know, I was afraid. I said,
it's going to capsize.
Yeah, exactly. He said, do you think it could have capsized? And I said, no, not really, but that's why you like to have a powerful engine, because if you start going up a wave, you want to make sure you can go up it and over the top of it.
Push you over.
Yes, exactly.
Wow.
So anyway, that was the adventure of the week.
But it works, the new engine, because there was trouble. There was all sorts of issues.
Yes, yes. Everything now is, you know, and now I have a single gauge, and I'll make a little video for the show one time. You know, now instead of 10 different gauges, I have a 5-inch display.
Yeah.
And it reads everything, and I'm looking, and I said to Dennis, where did they put someone took the engine hour meter. And then I start clicking through the menus, and it says, your engine has now run for 3.3 hours.
Wow.
Everything's built into the gauge.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That is fantastic. Does it feel like a whole new boat, or it just feels like a new engine?
It feels like, you know, the other engine was 15 years old.
Right.
And, I mean, if you put the throttle all the way forward, the boat went a little bit faster. But this, when you put the throttle forward on this, you kind of like hold on because
that's nice.
Yeah, it is.
So that's that great. Was
yeah. And how about you?
Oh man, what happened? So over the weekend I went camping with my family.
Oh yes.
And it was just absolutely fantastic. Took Charlie with me. We did some training on him because he got very excited around the campsite. Had a really great weekend, and I was an Eagle Scout, did a lot of Boy Scout camping, and so I haven't been camping in a long, long time, so it was great to get back to that.
And do you camp in the Hilton or do you camp at the Sheraton?
I camp at the at a very intense place, a tent, actually.
Oh, okay. Oh, the Intense Inn.
The Intense Inn, exactly.
Yeah.
It was great. I just had a really, really fun time. It's at Fort Parker was where we went, which is about 2 hours outside of Dallas. And there's this great lake that has a dock, and you can go fishing off of it. And we actually rented shelters, which are screened-in shelters. So inside there's enough space to put a cot or something like that. There's also a table and a light bulb with a one plug. And so mom and dad got a shelter. My older sister got a shelter. My younger sister got in a tent, and I got in a tent. And so we had a nice little campsite there. And
now, when you said you got in a tent in a shelter, or you got into a tent on the ground?
On the ground, yeah. No, I was roughing it. They were. I think it's called glamping, glamour camping.
Glamping. Okay.
I was in an actual tent on the ground. It's so funny because things have changed so much since the first time that I went camping. I remember the first times that we went camping and we had cell phones. And, you know, the dads would get out and just try to find signal and, oh, it's so difficult. Maybe you could call someone from the road. Maybe. And then this last camp out, I thought it'd be, you know, fun to just live stream. So I tethered my computer to my phone and I live streamed from inside the tent to Twitch.
Oh, that's...
You know, just, that's... times have just changed just so much. You know, since the start of camping, you know, you have LTE at the campsite and things
like
that.
Oh, that's very funny. That's very funny.
I thought that was funny. Just a sleeping bag, no air mattress, PC guys asking. But I did have mats, like an inflatable, it sounds like an air mattress, but you can buy pads that you just, you know, use your mouth to blow up about an inch, maybe. It was great. It was fantastic. And it was also fun to just take Charlie out and, you know, I go walk him or play with the ball in the backyard for maybe an hour a day, something like that. Maybe longer. Like today I took him to a dog park, but at a campsite, it's like 24/7, you know, Charlie time. And so he
didn't try to run into the woods or anything.
No, that campsite actually had a rule that he wasn't allowed to be off of his tether. So I brought one of those curly Q stake things and put it in the ground and attached a cable to him. So he had to be on that, unfortunately. It was actually pretty unfortunate because, you know, he just wants to be a dog. He wants to run around.
Yeah,
and so
right,
he gets
right.
tangled up in something. You have to go untangle him and things like that. What that campsite was all about. So yeah, it was fun. It was a great weekend. With that, I guess let's jump in. You went to the auto show.
The auto show. Oh, by the way, someone asked the engine that I got is a 250 horsepower four stroke Yamaha. So that was the engine, which is on a 23-foot boat called the Farallon. Yes, the auto show. So I go to the auto show. A man who has never ever owned a car in his life.
Yeah.
I go to the auto show to look at concept cars, which are always great. And I usually find some sort of a exhibit that doesn't really pertain to cars. You know, one year they had a beautiful motorhome there. One exhibit that was the best thing that I was ever able to do at an auto show was the DMV, the New York State DMV, has a booth there. And it says,
got your driver's license.
No, I have one because you need it to cash checks.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
I mean, in a dire emergency, I could drive, I think.
If someone needed to go to the hospital, you might be able
Exactly. But they had a sign at the top of the booth, if your driver's license is expiring within the next year to 2 years, renew it here now.
Wow.
Not for free, but you go up there. They do take they do the eye test right there.
Huh.
And then they type the results into the computer. And then the woman says you can now use the DMV kiosk. And you go over there and you put in your old license and you answer five questions. and you pay your money, and
you're I will done. Have, you don't have to wait in line at the actual DMV.
Exactly. She said, here's a temporary permit in case you do want to drive, and that will cover you for 3 months, and you certainly will have the driver's license within a month or two. So that was great.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, it was super. Maybe they, I don't know if all car shows do it or not. Anyway, the New York Boat Show, it's a New York car show. Two concept cars that were kind of fun. One that you and I are especially interested in because Nissan was showing their Rogue Dog concept car. But this first one from Toyota is kind of neat, and this is it. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv at the 2017 Auto Show in New York City. We're looking at the Toyota FT4X concept. So as the car comes around, I can explain a few of the things that are inside. So there's a full galley, dining rooms.
What?
Seats, I think six.
Is it an apartment?
That sounds optimistic. Maybe she said it seats four. Shower,
what?
A laundromat, and a separate place for your dog to play. Okay? And actually, it has none of those things. We're going to find their video that shows you what the car could do if indeed they were producing it. So this has no on-sale date. But it's a fun concept car, and it does a lot of fun things. Let's watch. Okay, so this is the concept vehicle, and this is a concept video, so it's animated. So you can see that there are, I believe that is a removable water bottle. And then we have extra storage, removable entertainment system. The armrest is actually a sleeping bag. And then we have a lot of storage, quick access storage. The rotating vents move way around, not like that little vent you have in your car. Removable navigation, take that outside. You can watch movies on it. Removable dome lights that also serve as flashlights. Removable panels, we have no idea. I guess you store them under the floor in the back. This one doesn't show it, but the woman at the desk said that they're going to there will be a like refrigerated section in the back door also. Again, this is all concept. A huge storage area there. You can extend the floor. So if you're carrying a lot of big stuff, this is pretty neat, okay? So there's no date for it to come out. I thought it's a pretty fun idea. Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
Okay, so it's like a camper what I just did this weekend.
Yes, exactly. and what I liked was that the armrest was sleeping bags, which is very clever.
Right.
And instead of having, you know, like pretty much every car I looked in had these big panels, like my boat, where all your instruments were on these panels. Well, this thing had a more modest panel that was really more like a tablet, so you could take it out.
Right.
And when you go watch movies on your tablet, when it's not being your dashboard. One of the neat things was, you know, while I talk, run that other video, because I didn't realize that when they make a concept car, it's almost like making a real car, because this video starts with them working with the clay mold. You know, you always see
that they use to scan in and.
Yes.
So these are the inventors.
These are the two inventors.
Kelta's project design manager.
And now, Ben and I are going to give you an up-close and inside look at the interior and exterior of our all-new adventure concept. Now, we designed FT4X with adventure seekers in mind. When your adventure...
Yeah, there's the
see,
model.
They do all
the
that. So this must be,
needs to be ready
ferociously
for
expensive.
Oh, yeah.
A really cool thing about this car is we actually started with the rear. Internally, we said the
just
rear
its
is
rear
the
door
front.
Is neat.
We turn this car
maybe he'll explain
rugged
it.
Charm. And so with rugged charm, there's actually four key elements to that: simplicity, capability, mechanical satisfaction, and then finally, Toyota identity, Toyota heritage. So
show
the
me the door.
And temp amps are integrated in a wide horizontal band. Little
very
bit
cool. Move on to the door.
DNA.
Yes,
it
yes.
It looks really strong. It looks
all right,
really
cut back
to
me. That's okay.
Really
here, we can just mute it as we talk over.
Yes, yes, that's fine. So what's neat about that rear door is that if you need it as a shelter, the door, the entire door opens and goes straight up, so you can use it as a roof. If you're in a constricted area, it opens as two a right and left opening door. The left opening door is a heated door, so when you're camping, you can have heated food, and there it goes up.
Oh,
so
there
that's
it goes up.
That's the
yeah.
way the way it goes up for ultimate access and for it to be a shelter. That's the armrest that is also a sleeping bag. And well, we saw that.
The
removable
bottle, right.
water bottles. And I guess they're not going to show the other part. But so one half of the door is a heating element, and the other half of the door is refrigerated so that you can keep things warm and cold.
I think really like that the entertainment center is removable as well as the
totally
navigation.
Totally removable, yeah.
Because
exactly.
then whenever your car gets broken into, you don't have wires hanging out, you know, once they steal the stereo system. It's nice and clean, removable.
What
they mean to do is if you're camping, you can pull the entertainment system out
yes.
and then it's a Bluetooth speaker or something like that.
Absolutely.
The
heated panel, the hot box, and then the cold storage on that side. This is what you need next year.
I know, right?
For your trip, yeah.
But of course it's a concept car, so we'll never, ever,
yes.
ever see it.
No. But you know, it's so funny. I always thought concept cars were kind of dummy cars. I didn't realize that they spent so much money.
I know.
Designing.
I know. I think that there was something that Steve Jobs said about concept cars. I'm going to paraphrase the heck out of it and probably
yeah, that's
get
okay.
all of it wrong. But basically, he says, you know, you always see a concept car and they just get it so right. And you'd think, yes, this is exactly what I want. I want this in my car. Why can't I have this? Make this. And then engineers say, oh, we can't do this. And salespeople say, oh, we can't do that. And advertising people say, oh, we can't do that. And so it gets toned down, and then you get the normal car. And I feel like that's every concept car I ever see, I think of that. And I think, this is it. This is the car I want. You got
yes.
the perfect car. It has so many cool features. I would love this. Make it, and you never see it, ever. You never, ever see that type of car come out. But yeah. Yeah, and it's incredibly expensive because, you know, the paneling on the side, that seems
yes.
all like a handmade. The whole drivetrain, the engine, I mean, everything is just is handmade to look like it's a mass production vehicle, but it's not. I mean, it
no.
must be millions, millions. Oh, my gosh.
I bet it is. Now, the next concept car is a lot cheaper for them to do. It's from Nissan, and it's a Rogue. So the Nissan Rogue, the woman told me, is the largest selling, I don't know what they are, SUV, whatever it is.
Yeah.
So they just took a Rogue and redid it as a concept car. So we can see what that looks like. Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at the 2017 Auto Show, and I'm thinking, wait a minute, why are we seeing a fire hydrant? And then I see, as you saw, a concept car. Actually, we're going to talk to Samantha. Is this a concept car or a production car?
Currently, it is a concept car. It's called the Rogue Dogue, and we currently make the Nissan Rogue, as many people
which is a very big seller.
It's actually the number one selling crossover in the automotive industry this year.
Wow.
So that's pretty exciting. It's a very popular vehicle, and we just spiced it up with a concept for to have if you have pets.
Okay, so what do we have in here? Let's see. We'll go on either side of this, and actually I'll stand next to you, so I can hold the mic for you. So what are some of the gadgets here? We love gadgets
here at Nissan too. So inside in the drawer here, these are all of the parts that you would need to give the dog a shower. So you can take this apart and you hook up the hose here. There's a 10-gallon water holding tank inside the vehicle, and you would attach it, and then you spray the dog as if it was a shower.
Oh, okay.
It folds right back up.
Is this for doggy shampoo in here?
Yes, it is. Shampoo, soap, and then it'll spray out in the stream as well.
Okay, great. So then there's some sort of a 12-volt pump in there that's doing the water pressure?
Yes.
Okay, and this guy?
And then you can hook up the dryer, blow dry your dog. And so that's pretty cool too.
That's pretty good.
And then air will come out of the back seats as well, warm compressed air, so that if your dog isn't completely dry, it'll be dry by the time it gets home.
Wow.
We have some hot hidden compartments here. Food and water bowl for the dog.
That's great. I actually see some water in one of them.
Yes, there is water.
There was food in the other one, but our cameraman Larry ate that.
We also had the dogs in earlier today too, so they were drinking the water.
Vehicles. Very good.
Yeah, and then we have the harness hookup. The divider can be removed, so the bigger dogs can run back and forth.
Okay, and we're gonna walk around the side. It looks like you have protection in the back seat to actually carry the dog.
Correct, a seat protector. Kind of looks like a taco.
Okay.
The seat protector will come down for the middle part.
Okay, and then the dogs will have like a huge area from there.
Back to front?
You can do that if you want.
Yes. If you have two dogs, you can keep one in the back and one in the middle and keep them separate.
Oh, great. Or if you have a cat, keep the cat in one and the dog in the other. All right, so a concept, which means it may be out in 2018, but there's no guess.
Nissan is just calling it a concept for now. Okay. No plans to produce.
Okay. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv, your concept host, not to be reproduced. Okay, bye.
Very cool. So for the dog lovers out there, it has everything built in.
Yeah, it seems like they could just produce this pretty easily, right?
Yeah,
they just
that seems a lot easier to make than the...
Because they already have the car.
Exactly.
Put in a water tank and a couple of pumps and some compressed hot air and
yes, exactly. Yeah. I mean, I like the idea of a reservoir, a water reservoir built into the car. That seems great because I mean, when we go camping, we take big gallon jugs. They look like the gas canisters on the back of Jeeps that filled with water.
Yes.
Take up a ton of space. If you could build that into the paneling of the car, that'd be so neat.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that seems great. And it is spelled. I forgot what she called it already. The doe.
Oh, rogue dog.
Rogue dog.
Dog.
It's spelled D O G U E. Dagoo.
Right.
Dagoo.
Yeah. Well, it's to match rogue, so it's R O G U E D O G U E. And it said a survey of 400 dog owners said 83% says their dogs are just as important to be safe and comfortable in their car as other passengers. 83% sounds low to me.
You're right. Yeah, nah, he's, I don't care about, Charlie, nah, he's just my dog, whatever. No, yeah, seriously, what, come on, 80,
yeah,
this should be higher.
Yeah, come on, they're our family.
Exactly. Right. Very cool stuff from the auto show. So.
Yeah, so we have the third thing, I have to thank, Dennis wasn't able to make the dog show, car show.
Man, you do not want this to be the car show, either it's the boat show or it's the dog show.
No, I don't. I remember one year ABC said, cover the car show. I said, I know so little about cars. And I said, so do a funny thing. And I kept constantly saying, and what does this boat sell for?
Yep.
And is the engine included in that price? Because in boats, it's often not.
Yes.
Anyway, Larry Gerson.
So what is
in.
The wake of this car?
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
So Larry, sorry, I cut you off.
Now Control 4, this is an exhibit that I'm not quite sure why they're at the car show. We'll watch their video. This is Control 4 at the International Car Show. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. At the Auto Show 2017 in New York City, what happens when you own an Airstream trailer and someone comes by with a can opener? That's what happens. Warning. Okay. So we're here at Control 4, and we're going to talk about automation in motorhomes. Is that sort of why you're here?
Well, we have plenty of customers that have done it in a motorhome, in a yacht, boats, all kinds of things. So mostly we want
no
to just expose what automation is to many more people, whether it be in a motorhome or in their own home.
Okay, so what do we have in this Airstream that is automated?
Oh, okay. So in this Airstream, we have automated all of the lighting, audio, video, security, and even comfort. So everything that you would see in a home has been automated here. You know, in a control forum, on average, you have 40 devices. This has 40 different devices just packed into this,
into this one Airstream.
Into this one Airstream, that's
Can
right.
Can we go on there to see what the... Now, is the interior of this totally done over to, or is this what the Airstream would look like inside?
We totally did all of this just to meet our needs.
Oh, okay, okay. And how big an Airstream is this?
This is a 28-foot Airstream.
A 28-foot Airstream, okay. Yeah, because I assume in a 28-foot Airstream, you wouldn't have a TV, an LCD screen quite that big.
Well, it depends on priorities. You'll notice later that the TV is bigger than the bed. And for some people, hey, that's what they prefer, right?
Okay. Does the TV fold down so an extra person can sleep on it?
No, but that's a good idea.
That's a good idea. I want credit for that.
LCD Murphy.
Okay,
bed.
So oh, now that's great. Yeah. Actually, you made a mini bed here. Does that electronically come out, or it's just a demo bed?
It's just a demo bed. You know, we want to show people what automation is like in a lifestyle type setting, so that's what we did. One of the really cool things that I think you'll get a kick out of is this right here.
Okay.
Do you know what that is? It's a wall, but it's also the speaker.
Oh, okay.
So we have invisible speakers installed.
There's not even a grill or anything.
Not even a grill. Now, this is behind Formica, but you could do the same thing with just plain old drywall. You put it in the drywall, put a little bit of mud, paint. Yeah, it is working.
Can we hear it? Now, this I like. A wall, no grill. There's nothing you can feel, but the wall plays. I remember that. It's an old horror movie. The wall plays. Okay.
There it is. Holding the microphone up to the wall.
It was a foggy day in New York City. I was walking through the car show, feeling really low. My career was in the toilet. By the way, does this place have a toilet?
No.
Okay, I'm glad. Darn it, you're going to have to go somewhere else.
Right. Well, when you find one with a toilet, you'll find my career. Okay. And so are they flat speakers, or how does the technology of a wall speaker, what is the technology?
Yeah, so it's very interesting. It's a flat speaker, and it puts right onto the wall, and then it resonates out using the material that it's up against to amplify the sound.
Okay, yeah. So you couldn't do it against concrete, but you would do it against wood and Formica?
Sure, yep. There's a small piece of material that has thousands of little cells that help amplify the sound, and that's what you put up against the material. So you put a thin slice of mud, a layer of mud over that, or we just put that up against the Formica here.
Wow. Now, that sounds really interesting. Is there one other bizarre, unusual thing in here before we go?
Thermostat is hidden in the same way, actually.
So okay.
The problem with everybody's homes today, you've got all this wall acne, you see everything all over the wall. And sometimes that's fun, but most of the time not. So with the thermostat right here, the remote temperature sensor is right here. So you don't need to see it. And you put the actual thermostat in the closet so that you can have a comfortable home, but all that technology.
Now, when you say the thermostat, like, can I run my hand and that will lower it?
No, just the sensor for it.
Oh, the sensor.
To lower it, you could use voice control with Amazon Alexa.
Oh, okay.
Or you could use a touch screen or your mobile phone. There are a lot of other ways that you could do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so I am amazed still by the speaker. The thermostat. Not so much.
That's okay.
Brad, control4.com?
Control4.com.
Control4.com. Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
That's really cool. Yeah, and so what he means by the thermostat, everyone thinks of the thermostat as the thing that you control, but also a big thing about the thermostat is the temperature sensor. It has the thermometer inside of it.
It's just the sensor that he's talking about.
And you can't put a thermostat into a thermostat that you would think of right off the bat into a closet because it needs to have access to moving air, the air that you live in, to tell the temperature. A closet may be hotter or colder than the rest of the house because it's all closed up. So you need the sensor to be somewhere that actual people are in order to tell the temperature. So that's why.
So that's kind of amazing then that the sender is behind something.
It's right. It's like it's integrated into a panel in the wall that it's sensitive enough to tell the temperature on the other side.
What is mud? He said mud twice.
Spackle.
You take a speaker and you put mud. What is it?
That's just like spackle. It's just like a type of adhesive or a building material basically to make sure that it stays together. Some people call it different things, basically.
Also, that's an expression I never heard before. It was so funny when he's talking about people have thermostats and switches and things, and he referred to it as wall acne.
Wall acne. I thought that was interesting.
Isn't that funny?
Yeah. I can never think of the light switches on my wall the same ever again.
Wall acne.
Oh, my gosh. Is my art, is my pictures wall acne? Is the mirrors,
mirrors? The ones you don't like are.
Is that wall acne?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Was interesting is you may have noticed in one of those shots, there was like a big empty space behind me. I don't know how telling this is, but that whole area behind me that is now empty used to be the electric car test track.
Wow.
And they would have every company that made an electric car would have a version of theirs so that people could drive them. And there was no electric car test track at all. And I'm wondering.
Maybe it's because they become so prevalent and so, everyone's seeing an electric car now. Whatever.
Yeah, but maybe that's it.
Or maybe it's just like, I don't know. Yeah.
Maybe hybrid people are thinking, well, hybrid's easier. I don't have to drag an extension cord behind me.
Right.
All right. So that's Dickie D's look at the International Car Show, which means, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Chad's.
No, you don't need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner. Get it.
Okay. So we are back at it with the Magnetic Month.
Yes, I love this month.
It's fun. It's been really good. So this gadget, I've seen around the internet before. I've seen Kickstarters for similar gadgets, and it was something that I always kind of wanted to try, but never actually got myself to buy. And now I have an excuse. It was for the Giz Wiz. So I'm checking out magnetic cables. That's right. These cables use a little adapter that plugs into your phone and you leave it there and then a magnetic cable portion to clip onto the cable. And what this reminds me of is Apple has a product called MagSafe
connectors. Yeah, on laptops, right?
On laptops. And when those came out, I mean, it was just absolutely amazing because instead of plugging in to a port where if you trip on it, it's almost guaranteed to be flung and fall off tables and cause issues inside of classrooms. And the MagSafe, because it's magnetic, hopefully whenever you bump the cord, it would just pop right out. But it has enough attraction to stay in whenever it's charging. I have also seen sometimes the magnet is too powerful and the laptop still falls on the ground. But in most cases, it works just great. So inside of the case, there's no instructions, no paperwork at all, just the cable, and you have two of the connectors. You have a micro USB and you have a lightning. And so I've actually already attached the lightning inside. Here's the little micro USB. You can see that it is very small, and the lightning when it's in there, there's a little bit of a bump on the bottom, but not much. And we can pull that out. Oh, and now I've lost it forever. Oh gosh, 1 second. I gotta go grab that. The lightning cable uses plastic. I don't know if this is gonna be an issue for people, but you can kind of see that that's white plastic. A lot of lightning cables are completely metal, but this uses kind of plastic in the middle. I don't know if that's an issue for anybody. But you go ahead and just drop it right onto the bottom of the phone, just like so. You push it in. There you go. And now it is attached, and you could just leave that right on there. So in order to test this, I have one of my anchor batteries. We'll go ahead and plug this into the battery and start that a-charging. And then let me also just clear my screen so you don't see any notifications. There we go. And when we plug it in, you should see the charging icon. And there we go. Wow. It's charging. So you can see that it's...
It's quite nice. Neat.
There you go. Now it's charging. Now it's not. Unplug it.
So does every box include both connectors? I guess they save time that way by not having to order something specific for Android.
Exactly. Or if you had another product that used micro USB, like say a video game controller.
There's
so many products that use micro USB. You wouldn't have to worry about it. It is nice. You don't have to worry about which either side you use. There's one side that is kind of clean and another side that has a green LED on it. And so you can attach either side and it will still, let's flip it over, it will still charge your phone.
Oh, you know, I like that.
I do too. I got to say that I find it pretty nice. It's not, it's pretty good. I think that's nice. Let's see if it can hold the phone, kind of hold the phone upside down. I don't trust it too much.
No.
there we go. I think now, and I mean, my other fear would be that while using it, you know, a lot of times you'd charge this in bed, but right before you go to bed, you're looking at your phone and checking things. It would easily kind of bump out if you were using it that way. I gotta say that it's pretty nice. I could see jumping into a car and quickly, you know, instead of plugging, you know, fiddling with the bottom of the phone to charge your phone, you just kind of slap it on there. It seems to work just fine. Yeah.
And what brand is that?
There we go.
Company?
So this is Sphericals off of Amazon, and it didn't cost too much. It was $15, and there's a lot of options for these. This version comes in two different colors. It comes in the gold and silver. But if you search for magnetic cables, I mean, there are just tons and tons and tons.
Oh my word,
of magnetic cables. Some of these aren't magnetic, but like this one is and that one is. There are lots of cables out there. I just kind of went for one that was the highest rated and with the most reviews. Don't be fooled by the magnetic feature. You should listen to previous reviews. They all complained that about the magnet, and it's true, it's terrible. I don't think that it's so terrible.
Held your phone by the wire.
Exactly. I don't think that it's too horrible. There may be separate issues. That black that looks nice. That's a nice color. I should have gotten the black one. But yeah, there you go. Whoa, that one looks like it kind of broke a little bit. There's normally a silver outline.
A shelter around it, yeah.
Yeah. But, accessory was not...
Oh, and that's what happens to you after you use it for a month.
Exactly,
back to that
there you go.
When we see you next week and you look like that, I'll say, Chad, you got to stop using that magnetic charging.
Yeah. Now, this is interesting that the cable accessory is not certified because it is... in order to have a cable that charges correctly, it needs to be Apple certified. And it seems like it worked on my phone. I'm surprised that it didn't work on the others. But yeah, it seems to be working. The green light at the bottom does not change. It seems like it stays green and no matter what it's doing.
It just shows you that there's power.
It just shows you that there's power going to it. So that works. But other than that, I say that I'm pretty happy with it. This is about a 3-foot cord. It is the nylon wrapped instead of just pure rubber around it.
And all in all, I say that this was a pretty okay purchase. And of course, you could search around and find other options for longer cords and things like that. Sphericals, iPhone and Android. Magnetic cable for micro and
lightning.
There we go. Another magnet product in the bank. With that, let's jump to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn
on. Our letter comes from Laura T., who writes, hi, Dick and Chad. I hope this video is of acceptable quality for you to use. I am legally blind, and I find finding the camera to look at is sometimes hard for me while navigating the product. You and Chad make it so easy. I love this product. I didn't have time to review all the features, but here is my favorite gadget, or one of my favorite gadgets, from Laura T.
Hi, Dick and Chad. Today I want to tell you about one of my favorite newest gadgets. This is the ResMed S Plus Sleep Monitor. Okay, I'm going to launch the S Plus app. And the S Plus gives you sleep monitoring in a contactless manner. This is the home screen for the S Plus. And you have S Plus Mentor, Sleep History, and Mind Clear, which Mind Clear we'll look at first, is a place for before when you're getting ready to get into bed, you can record a voice memo or type a text memo to get things off your mind. I'm going to hit the sleep button. It's going to ask you 4 questions before you get into bed about your day. Again, here you can access Mind Clear, set your alarm, and because this is a completely different system in the way it monitors your sleep, it can wake you up in the lightest stage of sleep, from anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes, within 15 to 30 minutes. And if you don't pass into a light stage of sleep in that 15 to 30 minute prior to wait to the time the alarm goes off, it will never go past your alarm time to wake you up. Your repeat options, once every weekday or every day, and then your default tones for waking up. So that's a smart alarm. And then this has a feature called Relax to Sleep. These are your sounds you can use for Relax to Sleep. And tell it yes. And then you can see here, this is my breathe. This is the pattern of airflow it's getting this is the pattern of airflow it's getting through the room at the moment, which it thinks is my breathing. I hit sleep.
Ooh, it does a little bit of white noise.
Yeah.
In the relaxed sleep, it tells me. And then this is the screen where I'm actually sleeping. Mind Clear is still there. My alarm. And I can stop relax to sleep. Or I can stop the tracking altogether. It tells me what time it is. Gives me my light level. And gives me my temperature.
And temperature of the room, I assume, right?
Backward in the monitor. I'm going to stop tracking.
It's like, you didn't get a good night's sleep.
But that sound that you heard will actually synchronize to your breathing and then ultimately slow your breathing. Well, that was my favorite gadget, the ResMed S Plus.
That is fantastic.
Thanks for watching.
I love sleeping gadgets. And for a long, long, long time, I used something very, very, very similar. I think it was made by a company called Gear 4. I think, and it used an app that you would plug in your iPad. It had to be paired, it had to be plugged in the whole time. And I think it used
this one is just $50.
This is great. This is fantastic because it was so similar. It uses some sort of like almost radar, at least the one that I had, to see how my breathing was happening. And then it could tell if you were in a deeper sleep or a lighter sleep. And that kind of smart alarm thing, basically, you set a maximum, like I have to wake up at 10. But if I happen to be in a light sleep, 30 minutes before, go ahead and wake me up then, because I'd rather, you know, wake up night, you know, easily ease myself into the day. I think this is fantastic for $50. The rest med, I really like these sleeping monitors, and also just tracking your sleep, telling you how much sleep you've gotten, and also being able to track kind of when you get good sleep and when you get bad sleep. This is just looks perfect. Gives you a little sleep score. This is fantastic. Yeah. This is a fantastic little gadget. For $50, I think mine cost a lot more. Luckily, I got a review unit, and then they didn't want it back, so I got to keep it. But I absolutely loved mine, and I used it for a long time, for I think over a year, maybe two, when I was in Petaluma. So there you go.
Great. So Laura T, thank you so much for your video. I think this week two other people sent in videos. But that doesn't happen often. So we're always looking for more videos. And like Laura T, it can be your favorite gadget. We love it if you have something old in the attic or down the basement or even that kitchen drawer. Video about that is good. Something astounding you just bought and love, sent us a video about that. And basically, Dick's Gadget Warehouse has turned into a viewer video warehouse. So anything you have, make a video, 2 to 3 minutes. It can even be 1 minute, like our video last week from the video last week was about the
What was that? It was the
father.
It was from Jaden.
Yes, Jaden. Jaden, we're forgetting your gadget, but we were impressed by it. I can't even remember.
We thought that it was really cool.
So send it to mail at gizwiz.tv.
Oh, it was the fan.
The
iPhone fan.
The iPhone fan that plugs into the USB jack. And actually, I was going to buy one. I was reading some of the reviews. So you shouldn't have your phone trying to make phone calls or anything. A lot of people said it doesn't let the phone do anything the fan is in there. So beware of that. Just read the reviews too. Send it to GizWiz, mail at gizwiz.tv. 1 to 3 minute video. Put it on YouTube, and when you upload it, hit the drop down menu. Put it as unlisted. I think someone this week sent us a video that marked as private, because when I went to view it, it just says, "You cannot see this video.
You are not allowed. None shall pass.
You are not. You are not licensed to see this video." And that's it.
Perfect. With that, let's move on to the letter.
And surprisingly, it almost became a theme at the end of this show. The letter is from Steve Overton, who writes, "Hi, Dick and Chad. I watched the episode where you highlighted the gadget called Tap Do. That was the thing where every part of your finger and your hand, you touch that and it can do
a function.
Use
a fingerprint from everywhere on your hand.
Everywhere, right. Like 23 different functions with one hand. You highlighted Tapdo. Its case use seemed elusive. But what about a blind or slightly impaired person?
Oh, wow.
I had a friend who was blind from birth, completely self-sufficient, never got the hang of a smartphone. With this gadget, he could have maneuvered around his phone with ease, probably faster than I can. At about $100, it would seem that it's worth it." Well, I guess you would need someone to do the programming for you.
Or you could fumble through, you know, a lot have like a voiceover feature, but then it makes it so slow if you want to But yeah, you might be able to use a voiceover feature to set it up and then
just set it up.
Way right. quicker access with Tap2.
Thanks for the great shows. Thanks for finding great gadgets and some crappy gadgets as well. Steve Overton. So thank you, Steve.
Perfect.
For the suggestion.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, a product like that, I think where it really shines is what are users going to make it work? Something that's that customizable. I mean, that's what IFTTT, you know, was all about. Like at its base, okay, something does something, it does something else. That's all IFTTT ever did. But the way that users made things happen with it was really where it shined. So I think Tap2 could easily have a life beyond, you know, basically what we talked about because it's so customizable in the end. With that, we want to give a big thank you to our Patreon supporters. Patreon.com is a place where you can support independent content creators. And that's us. We have a Patreon page, patreon.com/GizWiz, where you pledge a reoccurring payment for every episode that we put up. Big, big thanks to you guys for your support. Absolutely love you guys. Without it, the show would not happen. So a big, sincere thank you. Also, some people do not want to support every episode. We totally understand. If you want to give a one-time donation, there's a Patreon tab on our website. And you can scroll down behind underneath the banner, and there's a PayPal link there. Hey, while you're at the website, you can catch the show live at around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time, just right here on the main page. You can join the chat room. Or if you don't want to see live, we have all the old episodes to all of our gadgets, and you can also subscribe so you never miss an episode. Our iTunes, RSS, and YouTube is all right there. Also, head on over to our other site, gizwiz.biz. There, Dick has write-ups about all the gadgets that we covered. And also, what the heck is it? It's the game show that really isn't a game show. It's a fun little thing that you can do. You take a look at this gadget, and we're going to you figure out what the heck this is. This is a whole gadget, not just part of the gadget. And I'm going to say this is a stress ball for three-fingered robots is pretty much what
that's
that
pretty,
is.
That's pretty good.
Stress
pretty
ball
good.
For three-fingered robots.
Yeah.
This is what you are competing to win. Mad Magazine, signed by Dickie D. This is the cover of this edition that you're going to be competing for.
The June edition.
June edition. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, but 24 for not correct answers, for incorrect answers. But they have to be clever, funny, hilarious, interesting, and creative answers. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. That about wraps it up for this episode. See you next week.
I'll be here.